Hello guys, today I am telling you about Yagi-Uda antenna, log periodic antennas, prime focus parabolic reflector antennas. First we see basics of Yagi-Uda antenna. It is a directional antenna. So its directivity is maximum in some direction. The resonance in this antenna is directional antenna. It has operating frequency which is about 10 MHz. You can make it below 10 MHz also. It can be used for a distance of communication for the range 40 to 60 km. We can increase the distance also. Basically, Yagi-Uda antenna made up of two types, active element and parasitic element. What is active element? In any antenna, if you provide feeding to some elements, those elements are active elements. And parasitic elements, that is not connected to supply. Only active elements are connected to power supply. So active element in Yagi-Uda is driven element, and parasitic element, which is reflector and directors. So we see now structure of Yagi-Uda antenna. Which is a driven element that is connected to supply. Other elements not connected to supply. That's why reflector and directors are parasitic and driven is active element. Now we see radiation of Yagi-Uda antenna. Here we see how Yagi-Uda antenna radiates in the space. Now if I say I have only the simple dipole antenna, so radiation characteristics that will be some like this. This basic radiation characteristics if you have only driven element. When you connect a reflector element which is draw in a pink color, because of reflector element, now that signal which is going in left side direction, that will reflect to front, means right side direction. So now radiation pattern look like this. Now we see power radiation in the right side direction have increased to with respect to previous case, and left side of power reduce because of reflector element. Now we see next case, what changes happen. We have a direct element. Because of this direct elements, now this beam in front direction which will be getting sharp. So beam width of this major lobe will decrease as increase number of direct elements. So here we can see this will be the radiation in the right side direction, and minor lobes on left side getting like this. So now you can find minor lobe magnitude, that is decrease 1 because of this director element, and beam is getting narrow. So see, this is how radiation changes as introduce different elements. So radiation of Yagi-Uda for a driven element, that is somewhat this. So this how we get radiation pattern in Yagi-Uda antenna. Now we see designing. We see firstly three element Yagi-Uda antenna designing. So length of active element, that has to be calculated by 478 by frequency in terms megahertz. So this is calculation we do in terms of feet. Length of reflector element, that will be 492 by frequency in terms of megahertz, which is also in feet. And third is the length of director element, that is 461.2 upon frequency in terms of megahertz, that is also in feet dimension. Now we see spacing between elements, that should be 0.225 lambda. This is we should remember when we design three element Yagi-Uda antenna. Now we see advantage and disadvantages and application of Yagi-Uda antenna. Firstly, we see advantages of Yagi-Uda antenna. High gain about 9 dB, high front of back ratio, it is cheap, it is a lightweight. Disadvantage of Yagi-Uda antenna is for gain level, the antenna becomes very long. And second is gain limitation is about 20 dB. Some application of Yagi-Uda. It is used in HF 3 to 30 megahertz range, in VHF 3 to 300 megahertz, and UHF 300 to 3000 megahertz. Also another application is home TV receiver, and for point to point communication also it is used. Now we see second type of antenna, which is log periodic antenna, which is also called as a logic periodic antenna. This is function work on logarithmic base. Definition of log periodic antenna is: a log periodic antenna is an antenna having a structural geometric such that its input impedance and radiation characteristics repeat periodically as the logarithm of frequency. Usually log periodic antenna are considered as a frequency impedant, and so ultimately its radiation characteristic and impedance characteristic that is getting repeat periodically as a function of logarithm of a frequency. For example, if we have frequency which is 1 gigahertz, now we repeat that periodically as a function of frequency, then at 10 gigahertz characteristics repeat same also 100 gigahertz also. So characteristics of impedance and radiation that is get repeated with respect frequency as function of logarithm. If I say I want to repeat frequency of 1 gigahertz, then next frequency will be at 10 gigahertz, then and only say function is repeating on logarithm. Now we see example of log periodic antenna by having log periodic dipole array. So now I will explain log periodic dipole array. So here dipole are arranged in parallel connection, and angle alpha that bounds length of dipole, this is not a connection, by this green line. This is just to representing length of getting bounded with respect to separation. So angle alpha bounds length of dipole, and here scale of factor tau is equal to Rn upon Rn plus 1, where this scale factor is always less than 1. First we see log periodic antenna geometry, where this dipole black colored line, which is are arranged with respect to angle alpha, and placing of this dipole that is based on scale factor. So scale factor is Rn upon Rn plus 1. So basically Rn, that is where distance with respect to nth dipole to origin, and here Ln is length of nth dipole. Now see how we excite this dipole. For example, we have transmission line here. Transmission line connection is zigzag. Now here R1, that is distance between origin to L1, which is first dipole, like same to other, which is we consider here n plus 1 dipoles. So here scale factor is ln upon ln plus 1. Now if you see this triangle, then from this triangle even one can rederive this formula of scale factor in terms of length. Even like see, for example, see this the triangle which is happening, and if I consider for this part with ln, then this will length in ln by the reason is half a triangle which is considered, so that so this angle that will be what we alpha by the reason is this half triangle which is what we consider, so this angle will be alpha by 2, and this length that is Rn for ln, length of dipole, so this will be Rn. Now we consider second triangle, which is this. So in that case, now length will be ln plus 1 by 2, and angle will be alpha by 2. Distance will be Rn plus 1. So from this we can say of tan alpha by 2, that is for this triangle, it is ln by 2 divided by Rn. And for second triangle, ln plus 1 divided by 2 upon Rn plus 1. So ultimately we can say this will be ln by ln plus 1 is equal to Rn upon Rn plus 1. And as we see scale factor is tau is equal to Rn divided by Rn plus 1 is equal to ln divided by ln plus 1. So that is we can justify scale factor. Now how scale factor and angle have relevant? So let us try to understand that. So let us consider first case, and that is for large value of alpha. So if we have large value of alpha, then this angle that will be broad. So for large value of alpha, scale factor will be small. That means tau is small, and for large value of alpha, the design required small number of elements and are separated wide to each other. So ultimately for large value of alpha, scale factor will be small and design required less number of elements, and they are separated to wide distance, and for a case of small alpha, tau is large. For value of small alpha, tau will be large, and in that case design required large number of elements and separation between each element is less. So in this case alpha is small, scale factor will be large, and the design required large number of elements and are separated by small distance. So this is the designing of log periodic antenna. Now here if you see this log periodic antenna, then its radiation characteristics, that is getting repeated periodically with respect to frequency, and this is what wideband antenna, and that is what we are using it for lower gain application. And if you want increase gain of this log periodic antenna, then one can use multiple elements, so as you increase number of elements, gain will be increased. But for smaller number of elements, gain of this antenna is less, but it has wide range of frequencies, or which it gives very good performance with respect to return loss characteristics. So that is why we are using log periodic antenna in some application, and there could some other shape of log periodic antenna. Even we see here log periodic dipole array. Now this is the radiation pattern of log periodic antenna. In this radiation pattern, main beam strength is high, so the side lobe is also high. Now we see advantages, disadvantages and application of log periodic antenna. First we see advantages of log periodic antenna. It is nearly frequency independent. It is wide bandwidth. In log periodic bandwidth is wide. It having a same back to front ratio. Disadvantage of log periodic antenna. The VSWR performance is not so good. And also low gain as compared to Yagi-Oda antenna. On lower frequency, applications of log periodic antenna. It is used in television in very high frequency, which range is 54 to 88 megahertz, and UHF is 174 to 216 megahertz. Then second application, it is used to measurement EMC, electromagnetic compatibility. Now we see third type of antenna, which is prime focus parabolic reflector antenna. Parabolic reflector antenna is also called as dish antenna. Parabola is a two-dimensional plane curve. A practical reflector is a three-dimensional curve surface. A parabola may be defined as the locus of a point which moves in such that its distance from the fixed point called focus plus its distance from a straight line, which is also called director, is constant. Reflector antenna is a highly directional antenna. We see first the diagram. It is a parabolic reflector. This shape is a parabolic. That's why it is called parabolic antenna. In this, basically two types antennas available. Primary radiator antenna, which is feed, and second is secondary radiator antenna, which is reflector. These red lines are radio waves. These waves are straight transferred to reflector. Radio waves bounce on reflector. Reflector collect or focus on one point. Then through feed point it transfer. Now we see some key points of parabolic antenna. Parabolic antenna uses a reflective dish in a shape of parabolic, which is used to focus the received beam on a single point. There are two types of radiator: primary, which is also called feed or active element, then secondary, which is also called reflector or parasitic element. Parabolic antenna is a highly directional antenna. Now we see how it practically works. This dish is available at our home. On this dish, radio wave bounce and parabolic dish focus those waves on single point, and then LNB feed to next point through wire. Now we see radiation pattern. It is horizontally and vertically. These are major lobes and these are side lobes, which is also called minor lobes. Now we see advantages, disadvantages and application of parabolic reflector antenna. First we see advantages of parabolic reflector antenna. First advantage is it has high gain, which is range is up to 30 dB to 40 dB. Second advantage is high directivity. Disadvantage of parabolic reflector antenna. It requires reflector and drive element. Its cost and size. Its cost is high and size is also large. Then now we see application. It is used in satellite communication, broadcast reception, space communication, also radio astronomy and radar. Now we see difference between Yagi Udai antenna and log periodic antenna. Both are high gain directional antennas. The main difference between these antenna is that log periodic antenna support wider frequency bandwidths and are physically much larger than Yagi antennas. Consequently, log periodic antennas are similar to Yagi Udai antennas. They can be two or three elements Yagi antennas connected together, each tuned to a different frequency. This gives log periodic antenna the ability to work across a wide range of frequencies, whereas Yagi Udai antenna are optimized for one particular frequency range. This is the difference between Yagi Udai antenna and log periodic antenna. In this video, we see three types of antenna: Yagi Udai antenna, log periodic antenna, prime focus parabolic reflector antennas. In this video, we see their structure, radiations, working, radiation patterns, application, advantages, disadvantages. I hope so you understand all this. Thank you so much.